A new report from Global Financial Integrity shows that billions of dollars a year are laundered in the United States through US real estate. And lax regulations allow for it to happen completely unchecked. Now, researchers from the Global Financial Integrity Organization said at a minimum, $2.3 billion has been laundered through real estate over the last 5 years. And given that GFI only studied cases already reported or adjudicated, it ventured that the total value of property purchased with laundered money is even more staggering. And that certainly does not surprise me. This is one of the issues that I've been paying a lot of attention to because there's a lot of foreign investment in US real estate. Now, whenever you push back against it, people think that there's like some bigoted agenda, but no. Oftentimes, what you'll see, especially in these all cash purchases in US real estate that, you know, foreigners do not want to actually live in, is money laundering. It happens all the time and it happens in a lot of big cities, but now we're learning that it's also happening in small towns as well. So a United Nations agency in 2020 pegged the annual amount of money laundered worldwide at 800 billion or between 2% and 5% of the global gross domestic product. Now, the recently released Pandora papers also shed light on just how widespread money laundering really is and how the United States is really the top destination for dirty money. Watch.
We're looking at about 12 million documents from 14 different service providers. These are law firms, firms that set up secret offshore accounts for people in multiple jurisdictions. The British Virgin Islands, Belize, Samoa. These documents, for the very first time, is actually showing the US as a tax haven itself. We're talking about some of the most famous people in the world that are in these documents. Presidents, prime ministers, government ministers, the King of Jordan, a number of very high profile Russian clients, people that are very close to Vladimir Putin. We're seeing them buying real estate, we're seeing them trading in shares, using offshore companies. They're buying houses, cars, artworks. I guess it mostly demonstrates that the people that could end the secrecy of offshore, could end what's going on, are themselves benefiting from it, so there's no incentive for them to end it.
Now, there are some money laundering laws in the United States, right? But even the laws that exist are pretty weak. When it comes to real estate though, there are fewer money laundering laws involved, which is why Biden has decided to do a little bit, but it certainly doesn't go far enough. So Biden is urging the Treasury Department to revoke the regulatory exemption for real estate agents who are not currently required to identify their ultimate clients or to report suspicious activity. Remember, there's a lot of this money laundering happening, all of this real estate being purchased through shell companies. Now, the United States is the only major economic member of the G7 that does not impose anti-money laundering rules on real estate professionals. I've got more details for you in just a second, but Cenk, you know that this really grinds my gears.
Yeah, of course. Well, it should bother all of us for a number of reasons. One, of course, it's illegal, and if our government isn't doing anything about it, it's outrageous. And of course, it helps the wealthy, but specifically wealthy criminals that are looking to steal money from their home countries and bring it over here to hide it here. In fact, by the way, Trump Tower was a huge place where the Russian mafia would hide, launder their money. There was at least 13 people that were publicly linked to the Russian mafia that bought apartments in Trump Tower. There was a guy who came all the way back in 1984, Trump's been doing this forever, with literally $3 in his pocket and somehow bought $6 million worth of condos from Trump.
Okay. Weird.
I wonder if he was connected to Russian oligarchs even all the way back then. I mean, can you imagine? Now the Russian oligarchs, of course, run the place in Russia. And so there's a bunch of criminals that funnel their money through here. A guy like Trump says, well, they're buying my apartments. what do I care if they're laundering it?
Actually, since you mentioned Trump, I looked further into this story because obviously that Trump angle is an interesting one, especially considering the fact that many of those purchases were for properties that were valued far lower than what the money launderers had purchased them for, right? So like they spent millions more than they needed to on a property that was valued at millions less. But I also found out that in one of the National Defense Authorization Act bills, there was a provision in there. It was a bipartisan provision that had some laws, like some regulations in regard to money laundering in US real estate. And remember, Trump really made a point to veto that bill.
Yeah.
And so that provision, I didn't see any reporting on that provision until recently.
Yeah, in fact, that's mentioned in these stories about how the Trump years, they took whatever restrictions that were in place out. Why? Because the president was a well-known money launderer. He didn't want provisions against money laundering in there. Look, if you're unclear about, wait, why would they pay Trump more for his properties than they're worth? Sometimes by a lot. Because if you stole, make up a number, $10 million, you stole it, you didn't earn it anyway, right? You've got to pay a certain amount to the person that's cleaning the money for you, so they don't ask questions and they don't report you to the authorities as they're supposed to. So Trump would never report them to the authorities. You give him $10 million when the apartments are only worth 8 or 6. Oh, he's gonna take that money real quick and he ain't ever gonna report you to the authorities, even if you got no money in your pocket. And so those Russian mafia guys in the old Soviet Union then turned into Russian oligarchs in Putin's Russia. And look at the guys, the other two reasons why you should be furious about this story is all of these international criminals come to America because they think America's lawless.
Yeah.
If you're rich, you can do anything in America. Oh, the poor and the middle class, they got no chance,
totally,
right?
Totally, yep.
But if you're rich, America will let you get away with anything. There's no laws there at all for the rich. And so, and then the last part of it is they buy all the homes, and that actually does trickle down, right? Whether they're buying whether they're buying expensive homes or now they're buying middle class homes because they want to hide their assets even better. Well, what does that do? It drives up home prices because now they've reduced the supply, they've increased the demand, and they're willing to pay higher than market value because they're trying to clean up their dirty money.
Bingo.
So now we all have to pay more.
That's right.
Because criminals like Donald Trump thought, hey, I'm gonna make more money. Suckers that are in the middle class, if they get hurt by it, what do I care? They're suckers and losers in Trump parlance.
That's exactly right. So it hurts in two different ways. Number one, the bad guys get away with the bad behavior, right? Because we're not just talking about Russian oligarchs. We're also talking about drug traffickers. We're talking about child sex traffickers. We're talking about the worst people on the planet easily laundering their money in the United States. And members of Congress know it. Obviously, the executive branch knows it. They're not doing enough about it. In fact, in regard to what Biden proposed, it doesn't go nearly enough. I'm gonna go to the last graphic here. The Congressional Transparency Act provides a virtual GPS for launderers to legally avoid its reach. No registration with the database is required for companies that have more than 20 full-time employees, more than 5 million in gross receipts or sales and operate at a physical US location. Why are we offering carve outs to money launderers? Why? Right? Now that's the Congressional Transparency Act, but in regard to what Biden is proposing, that doesn't go far enough either, right? There's always a loophole, there's always a carve out. And you gotta ask, why are these people who are supposed to be representing us, who are supposed to be keeping us safe, right? Who are supposed to be representing our best interests, why are they going out of their way to propose weak sauce legislation or regulations that offer loopholes and carve outs to the worst people on the planet? Why?
I can tell you, mystery solved rather easily. So this is bipartisan, by the way. Trump just happens to be a flagrant and flamboyant example of the money laundering in America and then gutting the money laundering laws when he's in charge. But Democrats do it too. So the guy who is the clearest example is Andrew Cuomo. When he was governor of New York, and we reported this for you guys years ago, and that was one of the few good stories the New York Times did about him. They showed how he gutted the laws that would have the realtors show you who's actually buying the properties. There's tons of empty properties all over New York, and especially in Manhattan. It's criminals from all across the world. And guys, don't get obsessed with Trump or Russia. As you saw, there's the leader of Kenya, leader of the Czech Republic. It's from everywhere. Oh, there's Turkish mafia in there. You name it, it's in there.
Let me give you one specific example. In one instance, $100 million embezzled from Kuwait's Department of Defense was used to buy a 157 acre Beverly Hills property known as the Mountain. So it's all sorts of people all over the world, okay?
Yes.
Continue.
And as Trump said about the people from the Gulf, including Kuwait and the Saudis, he said, they pay me $30-40 million an apartment. Why wouldn't I like them? He's not gonna ask questions, but back to Cuomo. So Cuomo gutted the laws, let them cheat. Now you're, why would a Democrat let them cheat? Because his top donors were real estate interests. So when we, guys, bribery is the source of all corruption in America. When we allowed legalized bribery, where the Supreme Court said you can give campaign donations, unlimited campaign donations to politicians, they all became criminals. Not overnight, but I explained in my book, justicecomingbook.com, you can get it there, how it happened, exactly how it happened. And slowly, the Democratic Party, the Republican Party was overnight, the Democratic Party took a little while. And eventually they were like, well, do you want the money or don't you want the money? The ones with the money win, the ones without the money don't win. So they have all started taking bribes because they became legal. And after they became legal, guys like Andrew Cuomo are like, what am I, a sucker? I want more power. And so he got reelected. The media almost never challenged him except that one story. And he had his own corruption panel committee, and he shut it down when they started investigating what? His own real estate donors. I swear to God, you could look it up, okay? Because that's a ton of money in real estate. Mm-hmm. So they're funneling a small proceeds to the corrupt politicians so they can get away with all these crimes. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.